पर घट तक है तेरी कहानी पग पग प्यारे
दंगल 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 दंगल
सूरज तेरा चढ़ता ढलता गर्दिश में करते हैं तारे
दंगल 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 दंगल
ग्रेट मॉर्निंग ग्रेट मॉर्निंग ग्रेट मॉर्निंग सो वी आर इन लेक्चर नंबर टू. We are doing statistical concepts and market returns, that how these statistical concepts can be helpful in analyzing the returns. And again telling you, please have some more statistical skills, learn more skills apart from this CFA level 1 examination. It will be giving you more benefit in coming future. So statistics is the lifeline of an analyst, you know. When I am analyzing a financial statement, when I am analyzing a balance sheet, a statement of financial position, I am analyzing income statement, I am analyzing cash flow statement, I am analyzing statistics. With the help of a statistics, I am doing that. What is the mean? What is the EPS? What is basic EPS? What is deviation from that? All those numbers, you know, are being only analyzed with the help of statistics. So I will say statistical concepts are the lifeline for any analyst. So be aware in this statistical concepts. Today is lecture number two. And today, in today's lecture, I will be telling you something more for learning outcome number B. You know, as my all lectures are divided into learning outcomes. So we have discussed learning outcome A in the last lecture. So today is learning outcome number B. This is second lecture. And this, in this learning outcome number B, I will be basically telling you three parts. That what is the meaning of a parameter? What is the meaning of a parameter scale? Or what is the meaning of a sample statistic scale? Or what I mean by frequency distribution? So these are the three basic parts which are covered in this learning outcome. No doubt I will not be doing frequency distribution. That I will be doing in learning outcome number C along with C. So today's lecture is very small. I have to just tell you what is parameter and what is sample statistics. Please take out your registers. Learning outcome number B. Lecture number two, statistical concepts and market returns. And when I say a parameter, a very simple aspect, you know, what is a parameter? When I say a parameter measure, you know, if I calculate something for the population as a whole, as in the last lecture, I've told you that if I want to calculate average study time of CFA level 1 examination students all over the world, I have shown you the map also of all the students who are appearing for coming attempt, then I am calculating the average mean study time of all the students in this earth planet all over the world who are attempting for CFA level 1 examination. So I will say it is a parameter. So I should know what is the meaning of a parameter statistic. When I say parameter, it means anything, any measure for the population as a whole. I will say it is a parameter. Parameter means average mean of the population, average standard deviation of population. There are so many parameters. So please write down first point. It is used. Please write down. I am not showing you PPTs. Please write down. These are handwritten slides I have prepared for you so that you can write down. You know, it is used. Which is used? Parameter measure is used to describe a characteristic of a population. It is used to decide a characteristic of a population, that what is the feature of a population. In real world, there are different types of parameters. There are different types of parameters can be there, but I am sticking to returns, you know. For an analyst, generally he uses, you know, two types of parameters. One is mean return and second is standard deviation of the returns. Mean return and the standard deviation of the returns. And for explaining the parameter measure, I have taken this example of a Bombay Stock Exchange. Supposingly there are 12,000 companies listed in a Bombay Stock Exchange and I want to calculate their average return. Then I will be calculating return of all 20,000 companies, 12,000 companies together, and then that average return is named as parameter measure because that is of population. So just see, I have prepared the dots. These are the 12,000 companies which are listed in Bombay Stock Exchange. I am just assuming. And the return of all those 12,000 companies taken together divided by 12,000 will be giving me average return of that population, which is named as a parameter. If an analyst calculates mean return of all the listed equities in a Bombay Stock Exchange, then that mean return would be a parameter. But if I am not calculating the return, you know, of all those 12,000 companies, rather I am only sticking to some index. Let it be Bombay Stock Exchange, or let it be National Stock, and let it be Nifty, or let it be Sensex. It means I'm only calculating the average return of 30 companies or 50 companies or 100 companies, not of those 12,000 companies, and that is not named as a parameter. It will be a sample statistic. It means I can calculate the mean and the standard deviation of a population as a whole, or of a particular sample of a subset. Then that subset measures are named as sample statistics. Sample mean, sample standard deviation, population mean, population standard deviation. You getting my point? Population mean and population standard deviation will be named as parameters. Sample mean and sample standard deviation will be named as sample statistics. So the point is, just write down sample statistic, then I will be explaining you something more than that. A sample statistic is used to measure a characteristic of a sample. A sample statistic is used to measure a characteristic of a sample. Sample mean and sample standard deviation. So like this, we have discussed what is the meaning of a parameter. Now let's see, Google Baba, that what is the meaning of population, sample, parameters and statistics. You know, the field of this, okay. Let me tell you, what is a population? We are aware of the population. Now, what is a parameter? A parameter is a characteristic of a population. A statistic is a characteristic of a sample. Statistic. Parameter is a characteristic of a population, and a statistic is a characteristic of a sample. Inferential statistics enables you, okay, and they have given a very beautiful image that this is population and this is sample, and with help of sample we can calculate the inference about the population. So this is statistics, that is sample statistics, and this is a parameter. So there is a difference between, you know, there is a difference between the statistic and the population, which we will be discussing in the next lecture. Hope you have enjoyed this. Be happy, be jolly, be cheerful.